It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1583, recorded Thursday, August 11th, 2016. One bad egg. This episode of the Giz Wiz is brought to you by Kaspersky Labs. Get 50% off Kaspersky Labs premium software, Kaspersky Total Security. Use Giz Wiz at checkout. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, Dick has a monitor, a backpack, and a tiny volume device. It is the second week of my smart home crappy corner, so don't forget the eggs. And David has some Bose headphones in the warehouse. All coming up next in the Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the maestro of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing super, sir. And you?
I am doing well myself. It has been a eventful last week. It's been very eventful. I did a 24-hour stream on my Twitch channel.
Really?
That was crazy.
What did you do for 24 hours?
All sorts of games. We cooked. I had like challenges. So. If people tipped or donated, I pop a balloon and there's like a challenge inside. Some of them were like eat a habanero, and that destroyed me. That was like half of the stream was like me recovering from the habanero.
Right. And then there was that 8 hours of sleep that you did. I saw some of that. That
it was very exciting. It was exciting. It was gaming sleep. Yeah, a little less known about category. But yeah, it was a lot of fun, and that happened on Friday and Saturday. So the day after last week's show, I started streaming and didn't stop until the next day at the same time that I started.
Wow.
Yeah. So
amazing.
Yeah, that was what happened this last week for me. What else?
Well,
what about you?
Yeah. Well, I had a very exciting time. You know who Lin-Manuel Miranda is?
Yeah.
Okay, you know,
yes.
He wrote and starred in Hamilton.
A huge hit, Broadway. Is it on Broadway or is it?
It's on Broadway. And like that they've never ever run an ad because it's just sold out.
It's been sold out all the time. They even have like a lottery system for people who want to get in. You know, it's crazy. Insanely popular show.
So... The last November or something, the editor Mad came running and saying, "Oh, did you see what Lin-Manuel Miranda posted on Twitter?" And I said, "No." And he said, "So I went on and he had posted something like, as long as Dick DeBartolo is writing for Mad Magazine,
what?
Everything will be right with the world, something like that." I know. So I emailed back and I said, "Lin, you made my day, my month, my year." And he tweeted back, "Dick, you made my childhood."
Wow.
I know. So anyway, I got a bunch of Mad stuff together. And I happen to know an agent who has someone in the show. And I said, "Can you get this package to Lin?" And they said, "Absolutely." So about 2 weeks later, they delivered it to him because this agent only goes to the show once in a while. And then about three months later, I got an email from Lin saying, "Dick, I live a crazed life. Thank you so much for the Mad stuff." And I emailed back, "You know, if you want to come to Mad."
Hit me up. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, exactly. So anyway, another guy I know, does a series of shows called Forbidden Broadway. They've run for like 25 years, and they're all satires on Broadway shows. And he has a show called Spamilton, which is a satire on Hamilton.
Yeah,
you know, Hamilton. And that was easy to get tickets for. So I bought tickets, and we're going in the theater, and there is Gerard standing there, the guy who writes and produces this, and we started talking because we've known each other for years because basically we both write satire.
Right.
And we're talking, and Gerard says, you know, you picked a great night to come because Lin-Manuel Miranda's coming.
No way! No way!
I know. So I said...
And only in New York would this ever happen.
Yes!
Like, you know?
So I explained all the stuff about the tweeting and the emailing, and I said, can you please... let us meet.
Yeah.
And he said, I don't think that's going to be a problem. So anyway, we sit down and we're waiting for the show to start. It's a place where you get drinks and two seats away, Lin-Manuel Miranda comes in and sits down and loves the show. The show is all not only about Hamilton, all about him. And there's a character in the show who plays Lin-Manuel. He is hysterical, laughing. And when the show ended, all I had to do was take about four steps.
Wow.
And I just said, Lynn, it's Dick DeBartolo. Well, Chad, he jumped out of his seat and hugged me and said, thank you for all you've written. I said, Lynn, is it too hokey for me to take a selfie of the two of us? And he goes, I'm taking a selfie of the two.
Oh, my gosh.
So anyway.
Wow. How flattering. Was, how cool.
It,
how
yes,
how
it was,
exciting. Like, it wow.
Was, yeah. And by that time, every single person in the audience was now in line to do a selfie.
Yeah, of course.
So when I left, Lynn said, listen, I'm still taking you up on that offer to come to Mad Magazine. Anyway. And Chad, this guy has a lot of power. He tweeted that he liked the show. The show is going to close next week. At noon, they extended it by 3 months. So
yeah.
So the fact that Lynn liked it, and I picked up his tweet with the picture, and I have, I don't know, 3,000 people went. Oh, there. Oh, boy,
there's
you're
the
fast.
Photo. Yeah.
There's
the photo.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. What a cool story.
I know.
Cool
so I came home on cloud nine. It was great. And the funny thing is, Lynn says, you want to talk about a coincidence? I just bought Mad yesterday, and I'm in it.
Yeah.
And I felt like saying, that's a coincidence?
Yeah.
I come to see a satire of your show, and you're sitting
and you're
watching it?
There? You're like, I wrote you into Last Man. I knew about that. No.
Yeah.
Wow.
Anyway, it was a very exciting evening. Yeah.
That is so cool. That is one of some of the you know, in our entertainment business, the best thing in the world is when someone who you look up to, who you idolize, or who you enjoy their work, does the same back. There's no other feeling like
I
it.
Know.
Of just admiration for admiration together.
No, it's wonderful. Because Dennis said, I was so terrified he was going to say, oh, hi.
Exactly.
And he said when he jumped out of his chair, Dennis is so wonderful about it. He said, I was so proud to be married to you.
And
so anyway, so that was a very exciting evening.
Ah, that is just too cool. That is just too darn cool. I don't even know how to follow that up. That is so
well,
neat.
We'll do stuff.
Let's just
how
jump into some gadgets. Let's get into the show, I guess. Wow.
Okay,
very cool.
So,
very cool.
I love little monitors because I use them everywhere. I have one that always has Turner Classic Movies on it, a little 7-inch monitor, so I can just look over and see what they're doing. I have another one in the kitchen so that when I'm not near the big set and I walk into the kitchen, I can still keep track of what's on, mainly Turner Classic Movies. And I have another one that shows me the camera I have at the front door. Mainly so I can see when UPS and the mail truck goes by so I can run out and get packages. And I needed another monitor, and I found this little guy on Amazon. So here's our first video. Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. When you think of monitors, you think of Dell, you think of Samsung, you think of Sun Founder.
What?
Huh?
Sunfounder? Well, Sunfounder, it's a real company. Sunfounder makes little monitors, like this little 7-inch monitor right here. Now,
oh,
for some
adorable.
Reason, the Galaxy S6 makes it look blue when we record it, but there's not a lot of blue in it at all. It's a 1080p screen. Actually, it's feeding it from this computer over here. And what I'm going to show you now is a couple of the features of this. I'm just going to unplug the HDMI and show you that there's HDMI, there's VGA, this is your power in, and there's also audio video in. An audio video in is one of those little connectors where you have this part goes into the monitor.
It's like a breakout cable.
And then you
cable.
Have the
yeah.
audio
yes.
oh, yeah, exactly.
And video connections at this end. This cable doesn't come with it, but a lot of the other cables do. So a lot of people online are using this for the Raspberry Pi. And strangely enough, this even has banana cream pie input. Very, very, very rare. Now, these are the couple of strange things about it. One is, a lot of people complained about this wire. If you don't need it, there's nothing you can do about it because everybody's fearful to cut it off, and I'll tell you why. Because this wire goes to this harness, which comes with the unit. So what this harness does, this plugs into here. Then this makes it so that the TV can run off 12 volts if you want. So you can use this in your car. When you have the harness hooked up, not only do you have 12 volts, but you have two video in. So if you have cameras in the car, front and back, you have two video inputs. It comes with a little remote control, which doesn't do much, as you can see here. Okay, on, off, volume up, down, and you can switch modes with it. So, but what's nice about it also is that the controls are also on the front of the TV, which makes it very convenient. One or two of the dumb things. It comes with this little stand. And if you're not installing it in a car, you do need to stand, and I'll show you why. Because stupidly, the wire that goes to that harness comes out of the bottom. So I originally wanted to use
this. Is that the stupidest thing?
Yeah, it is.
Just stand it on the desk so it wouldn't be so high.
It would be such a neat little monitor.
The wire comes out the very bottom.
Why is that wire
required? But it does come with this.
Excuse
me. Well, and I do believe to hook it up to that harness if you need it.
So if you have your own little kind of tripod thing, you could use that. This all makes a great external monitor if you're doing videotaping on the road. It also comes with an AC adapter. Now, you're going to find a lot of 7-inch TVs on Amazon for less. As a matter of fact, I believe this company makes a model that's less, but it doesn't have all the inputs. You can get them down around $30 if you only need video in and you only need 12 volts. This one runs on AC, runs on 12 volts, has a built-in speaker. The speaker's not great, but it's certainly enough if you want to listen to a TV show or something. In your bedroom and you don't want a lot of volume, this has the speaker built in. So all in all, I liked it. I like it. And it's $60 on Amazon. So that's it. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. And now I will shut you off.
Bloop. Oh, man. Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, Sunfounder,
Do you know them?
I just love their seeds. You know, I eat Sunfounder seeds all the time. You know, they're just, you just got to get past the shell, but it's a little bit, you know, anyway. No, I have never heard of them.
I feel like
that wire should be removable.
Let it just come out the back so you could curl it up and hide it.
There's obviously a connector that is used to do the harness to that wire.
Yes, and people are saying, is it okay to cut it off? And you figure out, boy, you could short out those wires and have a $60 brick. So.
Why? And also, there's one connector for the harness. Could you not have put a connector for the start of the wire? It's obviously there's a connector that works.
That's absolutely.
Weird.
Oh, and the other thing that is Someone complained about it because I was thinking, how stupid can they be? Why do you print on the front of the thing?
Is that what it says? Seven? I thought that was a sticker.
No, it's not a sticker.
It's not a sticker. Imprinted forever.
It's imprinted. And a 7-inch, I mean, I'm going to paint it old, put tape over it. I just left it on
for the
show.
Yeah, it makes it look like it's the display unit at Best Buy.
Yes, exactly. And someone reviewing it said, if this company made refrigerators, you would buy it and you would open the box and it would say refrigerator.
Yeah.
And if you bought a stove, a big
200-something square foot refrigerator, HD. Yeah, that's weird.
Yeah, it's very weird. It's very weird. Someone in the chat room asked about, can you turn the display upside down? You can pretty much do anything with the display. You can switch it right to left. You can reverse it. I'm not quite sure why you need to do that. But you can flip it upside down. I guess that's if you want to hang.
And that's all in the settings on the
All in the settings, right
that's
on
That's
the
actually, that could be an amazing, what is it? Sorry, teleprompter monitor. Because monitors don't have the flip upside down, flip right left. That would be a really good teleprompter monitor.
This has monitor. And I guess also if you hung it from upside the down. Roof of something, you would want the display to be upside down. So that's another feature
that,
to point out.
So. But hey, all those kind of little awkwardness, it's only $60.
I know. And the HDMI out is great because I have one of those little kangaroo. Do you have one of those little $99 computers?
I don't. I think I know what you're talking about, NUC, which is the next unit.
And also, this thing comes in like a real box.
Yeah, it's not one of the there's a little Raspberry Pi.
Yes,
thing.
And it turns out that they have an entire website devoted to Raspberry Pi accessories. The little instruction book that comes with it actually makes sense.
Oh, weird.
It's in English.
What? This almost never happens for gadgets under $60.
You can't
get an instruction booklet that makes sense. There's also red flags that would make me think instruction book not gonna work, but like the printed 7-inch TFT color monitor.
Yes. No, there is someone at work there. As a matter of fact, in the Amazon ad, it says, if you're using this for Raspberry Pi, this website tells you exactly how to go about it. So
interesting.
So someone has put some interest into that.
And the built-in, I mean, if this is gonna be for a car, that's perfect. I mean, that is just so perfect that you have two video sources hooked in there already and that sort of stuff.
Yeah, and you know what?
Definitely has its advantages.
Yeah, I even think there's an inline fuse that they put in. So,
that's good. Yeah.
Let me just take a peek. Yeah, look it. Already wired in an inline fuse.
Interesting.
So
you can wire right in the car.
Not bad.
Not bad at all. And the first thing that jumps to mind is with all my streaming and stuff that I do, I want chat rooms everywhere. I want anywhere I look, I'd like there to be a chat room, so I can constantly, just always be reading chat room. This seems like $60 is a lot less expensive than another iPad or another real.
Yeah, one, and if you don't need the HDMI and the VGA input, they drop like another $20. So.
Nice. Yeah.
It is amazing. The first little 7-inch monitor I bought, I think it was $120. So they are dropping in price like most electronics.
Yeah,
thankful.
Definitely, there's been a trend, especially with monitors that. They used to be some of the most expensive parts of a tablet or all this stuff, and they're really lowering down. There's been a lot of buildup of monitor factories and getting the price down lower. So, so that's good. That's good. Cool. Okay. So the Sun Founder mini monitor for $60. That's pretty good.
Pretty good. 1080p too. So the quality is good. I don't know why. Even in the viewfinder of the phone, it looks fine. But when you actually record the video, It turns very blue. So
that
I'm
makes
not quite
no
sure.
sense.
Okay, gadget number two, great for back to school, really good if you're an executive who wants to carry a backpack. And, you know, we'll just, I'm going to run the company video because it's so well done, and we can talk over the video, and I'll tell you a little bit about how I found this backpack. There you go. It's from eBags.
The TLS Professional Slim Laptop Backpack. Another addition to the TLS family.
I don't know what TLS is.
Yeah, right? I don't care.
We wanted to build something that was really intended for the professional who doesn't want to come to work carrying a backpack that looks like they just went camping that weekend. One thing that you'll notice that is absent on this is there are not bungee cords, there's not a lot of webbing or mesh. This is really designed for corporate casual. You should be very comfortable wearing this with a suit. Or just
wait a minute, who owns a suit?
Starting at the front, a traditional feature on TLS is our vertical zip Napoleon pocket. Now we're using a locking apparel.
They have a lot of names for this stuff. Napoleon pocket? Who calls it?
Yeah, is that funny?
This is a great place to put your boarding passes, passport, foreign currency.
Oh, they're optional.
That you need quick access to.
Oh.
We've got double zipper pulls. Now we did put a little bit of photoreflective cording in here just for nighttime safety. We're using YKK RC zippers throughout the entire bag. They're the most durable zipper.
YKK is actually a very good brand of zipper.
Oh, okay. I thought it meant like yellow. Now this pocket's
good. We don't want it to be so thick and bulky that all of your contents just slump down to the bottom. We have zippered pockets all over the place, open top, mesh. You shouldn't have to dig around to see what you have inside. We have places to tuck pens on the side, even up on the top. And of course, we always include a key leash.
Yeah, but how about the keys?
Keys to a Beamer,
please. We include a water bottle pocket on the side. Zip all the way around. Drop bottom mesh. A little bit of elastic on the top.
Isn't that clever? If you want a water bottle,
you get it. But if you don't need it, you zip it away.
The bulk storage section for this backpack is accessible via an L-zip opening. Now, what we wanted to do was just make sure that you had really easy open access. Instead of defining a narrow opening at the top, by using an L-zip, you can get as much bulk in here as you want without having to worry about the size of the opening. Now for laptop storage, we've taken the same approach. This pack will hold a monster laptop.
Look at this.
Now,
oh my God.
Not everybody carries something this big, that's okay, but we wanted to give you choices.
But wait, you have something
on the inside,
bigger?
We're fully padded all the way around.
What?
And then we also include our removable pillow foam. Some people need that a little bit extra padding. Sometimes you'll have something that's even larger.
Who has a larger?
You might as well put your tower in there.
Another thing that we were sure to not overlook on this is tablet storage.
There's a
fleece-lined pocket right on the front in between. The trick here is to put the screen of your tablet against where the laptop is. Then you don't have to worry about any of the contents inside.
I want you to be contemplating a price, Chad, when this ends.
Okay.
Security is another feature that
we're
always
conscious
of.
I'd say hundreds. Easy.
And all of the zipper compartments on this main section will lock. There's locking
and
sliders
this is clever.
On the laptop compartment and on the bulk storage compartment. And with our innovative D-ring, you can lock all three zippers into one place, assuring that it's tamper evident.
All zip is locked with one
handles, lock. One on the top, one on the side. Probably the coolest feature on this bag, though, is what we call the AC adapter garage. Double zippers on the front. Open this up, and what you have is a compression molded hard case that makes sure that no matter how you've packed the inside of the bag, nothing is going to crush down and take up the space of what you have on the inside. So you can see that it's empty here, but the bag still has full structure around the front.
But
now,
wait,
really
there's
cool
more.
This is, if you this don't is want crazy. To use this feature and you need to carry something really large inside the main compartment, you can simply remove the AC adapter garage, and then on the inside, the floor flips up, push the lining out, fold the floor down,
and put in a projector.
And what you have now is a very large, totally open main compartment. You might want to carry a projector in here, some other really large objects.
Of course.
Again, the whole thing with this bag, it's all about
you might want to put your briefcase
being
in
a backpack,
it.
Of course, we've got to talk about backpack straps. Now, on the back, we have contoured air mesh straps, fully padded lots of nice venting up the center.
And they are just like a life jacket.
We have left off all of the crazy webbing and D-rings. We do have just a little bit of accessory placement here if you wanted to attach something small. But one of the big features of this bag is that it's very low profile. It doesn't look like you have a turtle on your back. Knowing that this pack is built for business, we've included a trolley handle pass-through.
This I love.
Back.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
On top of your suitcase. The TLS Professional Slim Laptop Backpack. The difference is in the details.
Holy mackerel.
Okay, so what was your guess?
My guess is like 160. Like, now, okay, there's two things. One, I think that may be high because eBags has a reputation for a good, I haven't heard very many critical reviews of eBags. I've actually heard of this brand before. And what I have heard is that they're fairly inexpensive as well. But still, I feel like the MSRP of that bag has to be 160. I mean, okay. At least.
Okay. Well, here the MSRP, no one's selling it for. The MSRP is 199.
Yeah.
It is at most places 110, which
yep.
I think is pretty good.
Yep.
And between the time I saw the bag a week ago, I found one place on Amazon that's doing it for $95.
Oh, my.
With Prime shipping. So, did I not send you a link to that?
You did. I'm just.
Okay.
I'm seeing there's some stuff in the description. I wanted to click that. So here it is. Yeah. Whoa. Actually, currently.
Did it go down again?
$93 on Amazon.
Yeah.
For the black and the gray.
Yeah.
The gray looks slick. Ooh.
Yeah. And that pass through for the suitcase handle. Can be vertical or horizontal. I'm not quite sure how they did it, but when they sent me one, I got my suitcase out and said, how can this slide down a handle? And sure enough, it passes through everything, and then it's securely on your luggage, so you'll never, you'll roll through the airport.
Wow.
Not worrying that thing's going to ever bounce off.
Interesting. That is very, very classy and nice. Wow, good find.
Yeah, I think it's pretty good.
I think that's pretty slick. That is a neat backpack.
With
a lot of thought. But the current backpack that I'm using, right now it has a space for a DSLR and a tripod, but I haven't used that space in a long time, and basically I think about a year I haven't really used that space. So
do you have the big one where with the garage you can actually put your car in it?
Yes. Mine actually has a yacht garage in fact.
I didn't know that harbor.
Yeah.
Wow, yeah. The marine version.
Right, exactly.
I have to look for that. Mm-hmm. I have to look for that.
Yeah. So anyway, this is pretty crazy. By the way, jacketreviews.com. Remember how I made fun of that Napoleon pocket?
Yes. Is it a real thing?
A Napoleon pocket is a pocket that usually located on the left breast of a jacket, on the exterior or interior, and contains the pocket that are usually protected by a storm flap. So it's the inside. It's that pocket that's normally on the inside that has a sideways zipper down and then a space, to the left or right. So it is a thing, apparently. One of those,
Becky,
I have some that has like a zipper and interesting.
Becky, I assume a pair of shoes should fit in there. And someone else asked something. Does it come with an app? Liam Lime, no, there's no app.
He started saying an AC travel garage, I started to imagine like a battery, like it was a plug-in battery that would have USBs on it and you would like plug in your device.
Oh, yeah, yes, it does sound like that.
I was like, what? Yeah. What is this?
Yeah. But it is a clever idea because the AC cables for devices and those transformers, they're big and they take up a lot of space. Here they just are in their own compartment.
Yeah.
And you don't have to worry that they're going to rub up against the monitor or scratch anything.
Yeah, I can't tell. I mean, I have one for my laptop, for my tablet, for my phone, one for batteries, for cameras.
You're
going to
need a two-car garage.
I need a two-car garage. That's a nice feature. That's a really, really nice feature. And one of the things that I love about my backpack is the bottom is constructed very solid. So no matter what, if it's empty or if it's full, I can set it straight up and
straight down.
And that seems like what they're aiming for with that the garage is that that's a hard
piece.
I'm
looking at it here. It's a flat bottom. Yeah.
That is
classic. That's right. Yeah, you're right. By having that thing in there, you can't put a lot of lumpy things that a regular backpack would have, which is let it fall over.
Right.
Yeah, it's very, very clever.
Very clever. So for under $100, you could get a very classy, stylish backpack from eBags. And once again, the reputation that I've heard from eBags is very good. So that is something that needs to be said. So that's great.
And you just said it.
I said it again.
Okay. All right. Finally, a very non-techie gadget that I use a lot.
Here we are.
Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. I love electronics. I love everything modern, except I miss a volume control. No, you can control the volume, but what I'm talking about by control is a knob. So we're watching this, and now we want to change the volume. We go over here, and then we click on that, and then you have the thing to control that. And what is that, 10 seconds?
Very finicky, lots of clicks.
Okay, so what I want is a knob.
Back to school.
Which I have. Look, ladies and gentlemen.
And I found one at
a volume
dash,
control knob. Ba-dum.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer.
It
is with one
can be it adds a volume control to anything you want. With a few limitations.
Now,
I can lower the volume. Just like that. Just like the phone ring, you're listening to something, the phone rings, no volume. I don't know. I just like it better than getting the mouse and finding the control. So this is how you add it. It is from Amazon. The thing is called Volume Box. And it's a simple little box. It's $20. And it can't work on every device, but what it does work on is any device where you can put it in between the source of the sound and what you're listening to the sound on. For example, believe it or not, I have it hooked up to a pair of Bose speakers. So this is how it goes. From the back of my computer, audio out goes into the in here. And then this control, this is in, this is out. This goes out to the Bose speakers. So you turn the volume on the computer all the way up.
Hygiene, and then cereal, blanket, socks.
And now I have complete control over the volume. So you can put it between a receiver and your headphones if you want. And it cannot make the volume louder than what the volume is from the source. It's a potentiometer that just varies the volume. It's $20. Amazon Prime, and it's called Volbox. And I think that pretty much describes it. Let me just see if there's a better picture here, maybe, of the top of it. And
yeah, it's just a simple knob.
What it is.
Yeah.
All it is a volume control, audio in, audio out. Simple as that. They also make inline little adapters for headphones, which are cheaper. If you look on Amazon for those, they're just about $10. But this one I like because I don't even like the little slider. That they make them with a cable with a little slider for the volume. I like a knob.
Everyone's going to see that.
I'll show you how great it works. This is Dick DeBartolo. And the Giz Wiz. One take. Bye.
So, I like that. You know, I agree. Having a physical device that has one purpose cannot be discounted. I mean, being able to reach over and inflict something versus, one second, let me.
Yes, yes. And what's so funny is right before the show, the monitor, I have a monitor here on the side, and every time I was getting a tweet, I was hearing a thing, and I start reaching for the mouse, and then I have to turn away, and I go, wait a minute, that's the TV, that's the computer with the volume control,
right.
So I know where it is, and without even looking, I can turn the volume down.
Yeah,
so
that's really nice.
Yeah,
and not expensive. $20.
$20. You know. And also, I always love how copywriters make what could be a liability into something. It comes with no cables, so that you can buy the length cable you need. Well, in a way, I guess that's true because they don't know how. but basically, if they put 2 4-foot cables in there, that would probably be enough for most people.
Right.
Yeah. So
this enables you to use your own cables.
Own cables.
For any cable length and quality level you need in your system.
Isn't that a riot?
Yes,
now,
absolutely.
I did get a couple of people asking, when you turn the volume all the way down, is it silent?
Well, does it click off, basically?
Yeah, it does not, okay? I have never noticed, but, you know, in an office, there's like a fan, and I have 4 computers running. So earlier today, I shut everything off. If you shut everything off and put your ear to the speaker, you can make out what is being said.
It
doesn't shut it off. But for my needs, boy, it's as quiet as I need it to be.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good. That's good.
Yeah.
I like it. Cheap, small. You know, it works with 3.5 millimeter, you know, cords. You probably have a few laying around. Simple.
Yeah.
Very, very simple. So there you go.
And that takes us to a word from our sponsor.
A word from our sponsor, Kaspersky Labs. So you've heard about Kaspersky before. They've been a sponsor on the show. Thanks for sponsoring the show again. Kaspersky is a software company that focuses on security, cybersecurity, and they have protection for you. In today's market of all the things that happens online, cybersecurity is not just one thing. It isn't just software. It isn't just your email or just private browsing or just password management. You need all of the products that do all of the things. You need a total security software suite, and that is what Kaspersky offers. They have a few different types of plans, but because you watch the Giz Wiz, you can get this Kaspersky Total Security. That is the ultimate protection, and you get that at half off if you use the code GizWiz at checkout. Inside of here, this is all the security tools that are included. You get your normal anti-malware virus scanning software, that sort of thing, but you also get private browsing. One of my favorites is password. You get a password manager. If you are not running a password manager, you are doing it wrong. You seriously need a password manager. So if you are wondering, you know, where do you start? I'm worried about cybersecurity. You know, this isn't just CIA level stuff. You have to worry about your own cybersecurity on the internet. What I'm trying to say is everyone needs to worry about their cybersecurity. And if you're wondering where to start, Kaspersky Total Security is a perfect place to start because it gives you all of the tools, not just a few of the tools that you need to be secure online. So that is Kaspersky Labs. That is Kaspersky. And you can get 50% off Kaspersky Total Security by using the code GIZWIZ, GIZWIZ, at checkout. And we thank Kaspersky so much for supporting the GIZWIZ, and you should too. So thanks, Kaspersky. Moving on to...
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for...
I hope the computer plays it. There it goes.
But you might want it at chess. Crappy corner.
Oh, in a box.
A box. Ooh, a fancy box.
Tell us, remind us again what the patrons selected as your month theme.
The patrons selected smart home. So we are looking at devices that will make your home smarter and more efficient. And this gadget, it's a little bit outside the budget of what we normally do on the show, but I had to get it. I absolutely had to buy this and test it out.
Okay.
This is from Quirky. We know Quirky.
Oh, yeah. Well, we knew Quirky.
Quirky used to be known as the company that anyone could invent for, and they would share revenue, and it was really fun.
It was a great innovative idea. I think this is one of the devices that did them in.
Probably. I lost audio. What's happened recently with Quirky?
Quirky got into the smart home business.
Uh-huh.
And I believe they went with maybe General Electric, something.
GE. This is from GE.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And they came up with this big smart hub. And I don't know what you paid for that, but I think that thing was supposed to be $60 or $70.
Uh-huh.
And then the smart hub would connect to, like, the alarm clock, I think, which would connect to the alarm clock would go off and tell the coffee pot to make coffee. But I think the hub was very expensive. Meanwhile, everybody was doing smart home that lets you bring in gadgets and appliances from many manufacturers.
Right.
And I think they were kind of doing their own smart home stuff.
Okay.
And then suddenly I read that they were going out of business, and I believe they did close.
Wow. I didn't realize Quirky was gone.
Not too far back.
So this is, let me just jump into it, and you can decide yourself if this is what did them in. I suspect it is. This is a smart egg tray. So you have this problem all the time. You look into your refrigerator and you think, how many eggs do I have? I can't count. I wish I had an app that told me how many eggs I had. I don't remember. I can't read the expiration date on the side of my egg box. If only there was a product that I could buy. So this is, I don't remember what the original retail price of this was. Let me see. I'm going to hit view my order. For some reason, I thought that this was a very expensive product. But looking at the Amazon, it was $10. I think I spent $10
on this. Well, wait a minute. Does this work by itself?
Yeah, so no, it doesn't. So, it did. I spent $11 on this. For some reason, I had memories that I spent tons of money. So, you have to have a Wink connected home hub. Now, that is not a Quirky device. Wink is
I was wrong. Okay.
A hub, the Wink hub is actually fantastic. I love the Wink hub. Wink works with so many different creators of smart home application type products. It also works with Alexa and everything. So, okay.
Well, then I was wrong.
Wink is really, really great. They do a few of their own products, like the Wink Relay and a few other Wink products. But this hub, it's $70. But I found mine at Home Depot on sale for about, I think it was $50. It was $49.99 on sale.
So but if you have one hub, you can hook everything to
up.
It?
Everything. Yeah, wow. One hub is all you need. Let me just scroll through all the products that works with this hub. That's the lighting. There's the switches.
Wow.
It goes into smart doorbells and cameras. Wow. It goes into the garage door and locks. You can even have thermostats. It even works with lawn and patio software. So this is an irrigation controller. Works with your hot water heater, window treatments, and Amazon Echo. So,
where's the egg tray?
You know what's funny is, does it show up here? Here, let me see. Brands, categories, brands, GE. It doesn't show up, but it works. And so on the I think that they too were embarrassed by the egg tray. but right on the box, I thought it said right on the box. Where does it say right on the box? There you go. Wink. It requires wink.
Okay.
To work. Works with any Wi-Fi network controlled from anywhere. So it is required to have a wink. So here's what it actually looks like. I pulled it out of the box. I put some eggs in it. Here it is.
Wow. This is expensive.
Doesn't it look crazy? But it was $11, right?
No, I think it's great.
Oh, yeah. So here's how it works is you first do a setup inside the app, and that was actually very simple. I told the app that I had one. I actually went ahead and just scanned the barcode at the bottom of the box inside of the app, and it automatically detected what product this was. So I didn't need to go through menus to even find it. So the setup process is as simple as, let me see if I can turn down my screen here. It's as simple as clicking add a new product, and then instead of going through all of this stuff and finding it, I hit scan barcode and then was able to scan the product. It used a system, you may remember this from actually, there was like a smartwatch back in like the 60s that the monitor would blink and send information.
Oh, I had that, yes!
Yeah. So what you do is you take off the cap. Whenever you take off the top lid, this kind of turns on and it kind of wakes up, as
you
can see.
Oh, I see it, yeah, oh my gosh.
So it's off until you take off the lid. Then once I connected, this is a little light sensor. So I put my phone right here and it kind of programmed this. Now, once it's all connected in, and that was a pretty simple process, then I have kind of a version of the tray on my phone. Now, we already have an issue, okay? So if this is the tray that I have, and this is the representation of the tray, do you see a small difference?
Oh, wait a minute. 1, 2, 3. Well, wait a minute. Maybe that egg is going to hatch.
There's no egg here. There's no egg here. I can't get
these. Oh, there's an egg. Oh, yeah. I thought you only had six eggs showing. You have seven showing.
I have seven eggs showing. It says that I need to use this egg immediately. It's not even in the thing. It's not there. So that was my first issue. Is so far, it seems to not really understand. So it just realized that I took an egg out, I think.
No, it didn't.
I don't know. Let's just assume that it needs to like rethink about stuff. Let's go to different menu.
I think you have to go back to the picture of the chicken laying the egg.
I don't understand this
and
thing.
Then start it again.
So the idea of this is that it can detect whenever you set an egg into the tray. And so once you set the egg into the tray, it will catalog when the egg appears. So I'll take an egg out of here and I'll put it over here. And hopefully it'll show up on the app. So it knows that I have added a new egg. There it goes. See, it realized. So now this egg, it says when it was placed into the tray. It's taken a little bit.
The date you put it in there?
It says I have 28 days left and what day I placed that egg into the tray. So the idea is that it can tell you not only how many eggs you have left. This is a baker's dozen of eggs. But also how old your eggs are. So if you're at the grocery store, it's pretty simple to open up your phone and figure out how many eggs you have. Oh, it looks like it's finally figured it out, but there's still this one egg that... So to remove that one egg...
Why does that egg have a blue circle around it?
That's the one... So the egg that is the oldest in your system... It will put a little blue dot next to it here, and a blue ring around that egg in the app, letting you know this is the oldest egg in your system. Pick this one up first. So,
but if you're at a store, you can do this, right?
Yes. So the app, like once I put this thing on it, it's going to assume, okay, you're not going to get it at the eggs anymore. We're going to shut it down. And we'll lock in what your eggs were. So at the store, you can see where and how everything was. So yes, you can see this at the store, just because it's assuming nothing's changed. So let's remove this egg, put it back over here. It's like, it's Now, okay, so a few things. One, obviously you put this into the fridge, so it's kind of a set it and forget it. You do need to, of course, transfer your eggs every single time. The these little orbs, by the way, there's sensors at the bottom so it can tell. And I got the feeling that it might be able to tell, I haven't confirmed this, it might be able to tell if an egg has gone bad. There was a little, for a while during the setup, it was saying that one of my eggs had a crack in it. So there's a chance Whoa. That it would be able to somehow monitor the egg to see if it's actually gone bad. But yeah, so that is the egg minder from Quirky. I still...
Well, Chad, do you still on your computer have the, what was it called, the camelizer?
Yes, I do have the camelizer. So,
you know, see, I think that was $79 or something.
Let me find it.
When it came out, because that would explain that. Who would buy that for $80?
I don't know.
If those lights went on and off to the music, I would buy one just.
So it says it only goes back until February 11th, I think, unless if I can drag this around. No.
Okay, I think Quirky went bankrupt about a year ago.
Yeah. Oh, here, date range, all. Here we go. I don't know. It looks like it may have started at $15.
Wow, you know, I'm going to just type in quirky.com and see what comes up. Da-dum-ba-dum.
It's now, okay.
Oh, might be back.
It might be back. Now, I'm having, you know, some difficulty with it. Also, the customer reviews are not so hot on this product. Great container, poor electronic device. There's some very disappointed in this product. This product doesn't work. As stated, in fact, I have never gotten it to work at all. There are eggs in place with red lights next to next used... Indicated green light is always the same one. Yeah, it's kind of what I'm having is inconsistencies in what it means and what it is. be careful. Mine's set no notifications to all the email addresses on my blast list. LOL. Yeah. So I'm not sure. Annoying alerts. Eggs has zero eggs. Calm down. Oh my gosh. Yeah. So the app may not be the best app ever used or created. And that's exactly what I'm experiencing here. Is if I'm looking, it's saying to use this egg. Use it. Pick it up. Pick this egg up. There's no egg there. I don't have an egg there. It says pick me up on the app. There's no egg to pick up. Please remove that egg. You know, it's just frustrating. I don't know if I'm going to use this product or if it will somehow one day work itself out. I don't know.
Wow.
So that is the Quirky egg minder. I think it has some problems. Is
thank goodness that you only paid $11.
Yeah, but you're right. I would have assumed that this would have been $60. I'm a little surprised.
Yeah, I bet when they first, because I remember thinking, my gosh, you have to pay that, and then you back then. I think the Wink system was a lot more than you can get it for now. I think it was like $100.
Yeah. I mean, out of all of this, I love the Wink controller. It's very fast. It's very nice. Yeah, and going to the Quirky website, it seems a little different.
It's very different. I have an idea that someone may have picked up the name, or maybe they just started up again and dropped all the smart. It looks like they're going back to what they originally did.
Yeah, which was much more.
I remember
low
pivot,
tech. You know.
Yes, I remember Pivot Power. Pivot Power. I have several in here. Is a power strip with an articulated joint at every outlet. So you could bend it in any which direction or just make a circle of it around a table leg. And since each outlet would bend away, every outlet could take a transformer plug. So it was very clever. And the kid who invented it, you know, was a sharing thing. You go to Quirky, if they like it, they produce it for you. And the kid had made, she told me that the previous year he had made $80,000.
Wow. Well, that's a salary. That's a good salary.
Yeah, exactly.
Holy mackerel.
And that was just for 1 year.
Yeah. Yeah. Here's a quick 50-something second commercial. From
Oh, Corky. Good, great.
We'll see what they promised in the beginning here.
This is one of the first products we did with our friends at GE. It's a very simple product, but it's absolutely amazing. It's an egg tray that goes in your fridge. It holds eggs. It holds actually 14 of them. And it actually keeps track of how many eggs you have at any given time. So let's say you're at the market and you want to know, do I need eggs or not? You just look at your phone, you look at the app, and it says, yeah, you need eggs. But the best feature, the feature I think is most cool, is there's little LEDs next to each egg, and it tells you what the oldest egg is. And you just sort of take it, and you see the next LED pops on, tells you that's the next oldest egg, yep. And then you go, and then bam, cooking some eggs.
No, that's great.
Very simple, the first of a long line of GE Quirky products that are coming out.
A long line.
And a very wonderful one. Go ahead and invent your own GE and Quirky products at quirky.com.
Okay. So, that's all it does. It just tells you which one's the oldest, and in a very bad way.
And why do you think they went to 14 eggs?
Because you might come home with a dozen eggs
old
ones.
There you go.
Okay. I don't know. That's just a quick
guess. That makes sense.
So that is the Quirky Egg Minder. Oh, one nice feature is that it came with two AA batteries installed, which is whenever that happens, got to give praise to the company that does that, even if they're out of business.
Well, you know what? Now you have a nice egg carrier.
Yeah. But, you know, it's I have a place to put my eggs, at least. So that's nice. With that.
Oh, so a Giz in the chat room says it's not all it's cracked up to be.
No, it's not.
It's a bad egg.
Yeah, it is a bad egg. Moving on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
And today we're using the Gadget Warehouse segment to talk about a new gadget from a viewer of the show, David Eckhard. And he says, guys, I think I sound horrible, but still have a video. It's something I bought from the local Bose store. And here is David's video.
Hello, Dick Chat. For July, Chat has been doing Bluetooth devices.
Woohoo!
I have my own Bluetooth devices that I got shortly after they released them in June.
Oh, the Bose Bluetooth
headphones. These are Quiet Comfort 35's noise-canceling headphones, and they do Bluetooth to not one, but two devices at the same time.
What?
For me, that means connecting to my Note 4 phone and something it calls AURA, because it doesn't know how to say Aurora, which is the name that my laptop shows up on a network as. When you first turn them on, it tells you battery 90%. Connected to Note 4. 10% battery usage is what I experienced when I flew from RDU to Dallas and then from Dallas to Birmingham. About 4 hours. Bose says it'll last 20 hours. And if you run out of that, it comes with a proprietary cable. The bigger one is normal size.
This is weird.
It also comes with a USB cable that I don't need because I got plenty of those. We all have plenty of those. It also has the airport dongle. Planes I fly on generally don't have those. The sound quality is pretty good, but you don't buy Bose for sound quality. If you want music reproduction, my brother has a pair of clips that cost half as much and sound way better. But it has no noise canceling. These are $350, which is only about a $50 premium over the QC25s, which requires batteries, which requires a cable, and you plug it in. I'm enjoying the fact that I do not have to plug these in. Thank you.
Perfect. Perfect.
David,
yeah.
Eckard. Yes, the Bose, I think it's Quiet Comfort 35. I think I went to the press event for that. And if I'm not mistaken, I think if it's the model, we saw four different models that day. But there's one model where you can actually vary the amount of noise reduction, because they found that some people don't like total noise reduction because it makes them feel uncomfortable.
Really?
So you can dial in a tiny bit of outside sound. Also, they put it in for people who want to wear them on the street. You don't want to have total noise cancellation.
Someone's like, hey, watch out for that car.
Yes, exactly. So you can dial it down so that you can have less noise, less street noise, but you can still hear car horns or people saying, hey, jerk, you stepped on my foot. Hey, do you know how many eggs you have in your refrigerator?
I do.
You're the wink guy. You must be the wink guy.
Oh, sorry. I lost audio again. Bose has been known for not the best audio quality, but definitely noise reduction. They are absolutely known for noise reduction nowadays.
Yes, they do. I believe I met Dr. Bose at one time. I think they started just doing for the airlines, for pilots who wanted noise reduction and the ability to hear voices from the tower over absolute silence.
Yeah.
And then they started.
I remember a good friend of mine, Brian Brushwood, got some of the noise-canceling headphones, and he got the in-ear ones, and he doesn't even play music from them. He just puts them in his ears and activates the noise reduction. And it just, you know, it sounds silent.
Yeah, they're great, because I have a pair, and they were putting new water pipes in the street a few weeks ago, maybe a few months ago. And they dug up the entire street with jackhammers, and my apartment faces the street, and I have two windows onto the street. And I thought, how can I possibly work? And then I go, whoa, my Bose. They were a lifesaver.
Yeah, so. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Anyway, so David, thank you. We're still looking for videos. I think we may have one video left. So if you'd like to make a video for us, 2 to 3 minutes, it can be like, David, something you just bought and like a lot. It could be something you just bought and hate. It could be a gadget that you bought and you think is ridiculous. We love those. Or it can be a gadget, and these are our favorites, a gadget from a long time ago that was outrageously priced, did very little compared to what gadgets do today.
Yeah.
Yes. And for some reason, and I know you have one of these somewhere, you cannot throw it out.
This egg tray is going to be the perfect one of those in about 10 years.
Yes.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I think maybe about 10 days.
I think about 10 eggs.
Yes,
you know.
10 eggs from now, exactly. Make your video 2 to 3 minutes. Put it on YouTube. Click unlisted when you put it there, and then you'll get a link. And only people who have that link can watch that video. That way, if you don't want people to just stumble on it, they will not stumble on it, because YouTube will not list the link. And send the link to us, however, mail at gizwiz.tv. And David Eckard will get the current issue, the October issue of Mad Magazine. He'll get one of those 35-year-old
emojis.
Yes. Alfred E. Newman pictures. So get us your video, please.
Please send it in. Mail at gizwiz.tv. With that, let's move on to the letter.
Here come the Giz Wiz letters now.
Oh, yeah. Our letter is from Steve Davison, who says, it looks like you and Chad will not be able to create one of those since it already exists. Oh, okay. Was it last week or a couple weeks ago?
I think it was last week we were talking about this, I think.
Oh, okay. And what were we're talking about hooking a vacuum to a hair clipper, right?
Right, right. So you just, okay. Yeah, it just sucks up all the hair. You don't got to worry about it.
Yes, okay. And we said, why doesn't someone put a vacuum on?
And you mentioned, there was a product that you mentioned, the...
The Flowbee.
The Flowbee,
which is this giant thing that you hooked up to your vacuum cleaner.
Yeah.
Let's see. You won't be able to create that one exists. I already found this on... it's the wall clipper with hose attachment. Google gave me this. It's called the Wall Senior Vacuum. There's a picture. But you know what? I looked at that, and Chad, it says vacuum not included.
Yeah, I think that you put your vacuum in this, and then there's a chamber that will suck up all the hair immediately once it gets clipped. So there's basically the product that you were talking about, the Flowbee.
The Flowbee. Actually, as it cut, it sucked the hair out.
Right. But it was also, I feel like there was like an extender. Like, so if you wanted to get a certain length, it would cut it. But so basically, I guess they do the same sort of thing, which is, I feel like the Flowbee had a different mechanism than a normal razor. It had, it wasn't quite, a buzzed razor. But what this is just a normal razor. You could add your normal, 1, 2, 3 size clips onto the end. I mean, Wall is a yes. Wildly popular clipper company. Yep, they make so many clippers.
Then you got to buy a vacuum hose.
Yeah, and then you must have either a vacuum with a hose or an adapter hose for your vacuum. It looks like this is normally bought together with glue. Oh, clipper oil. Okay.
A minute. Steve Davison, thank you for that. Which got me searching, and I found this. Oh. If you go to the link at the bottom of the letter.
Link at the bottom of the letter. Let me make sure I have it. I don't know if I do. Yeah, let me grab it.
Because this, I don't know how well it works, but I think this solves the problem in a very economical way.
Try to click it. Finding it. There we go. Found it.
Okay.
Boop. And go.
So okay. Look at this. This is, wow, it's only $32 and the vacuum is in it.
Oh, look at that. So that is the start of a little vacuum that is built into the Remington trimmer. Interesting.
Yeah, and it has a little plastic tray. I guess when you get it gets full, you just dump it into. It seems very cheap, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. For $30, I mean... Trimmers are expensive.
Expensive, and it's a lithium battery. Oh.
Here's a Remington video about it.
Oh, wow.
Remington's Lithium Power Series 4-in-1 Vacuum Trimmer ensures a mess-free grooming experience. Vacuum trimming. The future of no-mess trimming is in the palm of your
hand. How come he's got such long hair?
High-velocity fan blade vacuuming system.
Where do they find these guys? It's like they clone them in some factory.
Stainless steel blades into an easy-to-clean chamber within the groomer. Versatility. The versatility of Remington's 4-in-1 vacuum trimmer is remarkable. It includes the full-size trimmer to trim and clean up.
Show us someone getting clipped.
Yeah. To get close to the skin.
No, I think this is too sterile. Too sterile of a video. They're not going to...
Yeah. What a crappy.
Than a standard rechargeable battery.
Okay, well, yeah, I agree.
This also, is their slogan, true. Buy it and you'll get clipped. I don't think that's a good slogan at all.
Get cut at home and at work with the Remington. Yeah.
Wow.
Interesting. I think this is probably the best out of all the products.
Yeah.
Built in.
I mean, you're only throwing away $31.
Right. Right. And Remington's a pretty well.
Remington's a pretty good name.
Yeah, I've heard of Remington, but I also feel like I've seen the $10 Remington thing. You know, I was like, I'm a little worried that there might be a cheap version of Remington stuff. But you know what? I feel like $30 if you're the type that has the issue of needing to vacuum up your trimmings.
Oh, wait a minute. PC guy is saying it's a trimmer, and a trimmer is just sideburns or stash or beard. Can you go back to that? Is that ad easy to get back to?
I mean, yeah. I mean, it is. I agree, but I still feel like
a full-size trimmer to trim and clean.
It's a trimmer. Okay.
Oh.
So that makes it
so
much
less.
So that's
not correct. The same as. No.
It's not a clipper.
Got it.
Well, our chat room is really smart.
Okay, I see. So this is a more powerful device.
Yes. This is for people who really have hair. I could probably use a trimmer as opposed to clippers on what little I have.
Gotcha.
But you would need a clipper.
Got it. I did not realize there was such a distinction between the power levels of grooming devices.
Devices, yeah.
Interesting.
Liam Lime says, we're smart. The chat room is smart.
They are.
They're very, very good
at catch the things
showing
we don't.
Up to hosts. Exactly.
Yeah. You say it in the chat room, and then we take credit for it as the hosts. That's what
exactly.
Plagiarism. Fandom is all about.
We edit out all the chat room comments, and we just say, "Oh, you know, I know something interesting."
Right.
Chat.
You know, Dick, this is actually a trimmer and not a clipper.
Yes, Chad. I think we should make that very clear
yes,
to the
absolutely.
People who don't understand that one is just for the beard. And the stash.
Yes, and the other could be used as a hair grooming tool as well. Obviously.
Yeah, obviously. Yes.
Obviously.
Well, for you and I, Chad, for people in the industry,
yeah.
That's the kind of thing that we know.
As but professionals, we know these things. As yes. As viewers, we don't expect anyone to understand the level of complexity that is required in trimming devices.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Thank you for the help, chat room. So there you go. You can get a trimmer, a clipper, all with vacuum technology included.
Yes. For various prices.
Could you use this, though, as a vacuum? You have a little bit of stuff just around the bathroom. You just vacuum it up.
Yeah, now that's interesting. That's interesting.
Yeah, there you go. Another
well, all right, so
that,
now that our clipper vacuum has gone... Someone's developed it already. I'm thinking a hair length app.
Oh, yeah. A wig that decides the length that we need.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking of something that you look at it and go, do I need a haircut?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And then you take a picture of your head, and then you open the app and say, do I need a haircut? And the app measures your hair against the rest of the world.
Right. I have another idea. I feel like a lot of these gadgets that we talk about, they do a good job of combining two ideas into one, a vacuum clipper, you know? So let's stay with the hair, you know, scenario. I think we need some scissors with a flashlight installed. So you can so you can cut your hair while you're camping at night or when the power's out.
Yeah, or the Wink dozen egg washing machine. Now, that was something that didn't work well.
Yeah.
Unless you liked scrambled eggs 24/7.
And, and through the spin cycle, you know. Absolutely. Okay, so that is basically our show. Make sure that we want to make sure that we thank our patrons over at patreon.com. Patreon.com is a place, it is a platform for people to support independent content creators like ourselves. And our Patreon page is patreon.com/gizwiz. That's patreon.com/gizwiz. Big thank you to all of our patrons who support
this
the
is
show.
Our 67th
what?
Show.
Oh my gosh. We need to have a party at 100.
Yeah, sponsored by our Patreons.
Yes, absolutely.
So this is really great that we've been able to carry this on.
We try to do, to be honest, I still think it's a losing battle with how much the show costs. That's why one of the reasons we still had the sponsor, Kaspersky. But every cent that you guys send over, it really, really, really helps. And we are just so grateful. Thank you so much for allowing us
you
to
know,
continue
you know,
this.
So I'll just repeat our slogan. We don't make any money, but we lose less.
Yes.
Okay. Every episode costs Chad and I a certain amount of money.
I mean, gadgets cost.
But it's fun.
I'm sure you guys can imagine the costs of a show. Gadgets, equipment, flights to go to events. You know, Dick goes to events all the time. So all of that is where the money goes. So thank you guys so much for your support and helping out the show. If you want to catch the show live, you want to watch what happens live, make sure to head on over to gizwiz.tv. That is the place where you can see the live stream. It's also the place where you could catch previous shows if you happened to miss it live. Remember, we record live at around 7:30 Eastern Time, around 4:30 Pacific Time. And it's quite easy. Once you go there, it's on the main page. You can join the chat room. That sort of stuff. You can also find links to subscribe to the show on iTunes. We have HD, SD, and audio versions available on iTunes and just an RSS feed to use the pod catcher of your choice. And you can also subscribe on YouTube. Then all of our old shows are here as well on the site with links to both the products and the articles written up by Dickie D himself. If you click on the name of the gadget, you get to the article that Dick has written about it. Once you're on, that takes you to gizwiz.biz. That's Dick's site that has all of his info. You can play What the Heck Is It? But before we tease What the Heck Is It, I do want to say there is something very exciting happening in October. We are having...
Oh, what is it? What is it?
The Giz Wiz Meetup! The Giz Wiz Meetup! I'm so excited. So very excited. I'll be able to be at the Giz Wiz Meetup. Dick will be at the Giz Wiz Meetup.
Yep.
It'll be very similar to the one last year, but it's happening on October 2nd, Sunday, October 2nd, at the Boat Basin Cafe. Last year was my first time going, and it was so fantastic. I believe, what number is this? Is this a fourth annual, fifth annual?
I think it's five. I think it's five. Our fifth annual Giz Wiz Meetup.
We have games. We just chill out. The Boat Basin Cafe is a fantastic venue. It's underneath a bridge right next to the Hudson River. There's a fantastic little gazebo that we took over last year, and I assume we're taking over this year. And we play some games. We give away some old gadgets. It's just a really fun time, and that'll be, what's the times again? I forgot.
From 2 to 4 p.m.
2 to 4.
And if you want to come early, you can get a very inexpensive breakfast there,
mm-hmm.
or lunch. They have burgers and quiche, and but it's a beautiful spot. It's overlooking the Hudson River, as Chad said. And it's fun just to walk through Riverside Park.
Here's it from last year. Here's the meetup folks. You can also go to boatbasincafe.com to find their address and everything like that. It was so fun last year, and I hope that people can come this year. It will be on October 2nd, on Sunday, so just want to mention that. And also, big thank Dickie D. I have to personally thank Dickie D because I had some scheduling conflicts, and he talked
just
to the cafe.
Just a couple.
You just
said either the second or the end of the month.
Those are my two dates in all of October.
That's all right. That's
so
all right.
Many
a lot of it was dependent on if it was okay with the cafe.
Yeah,
so.
And they're a great host.
They're okay.
They're a fantastic host. So. Anyway, I want to mention that. So you can find out, you can go to the Dick's Login blog and see some of the info from the previous years. Basically, it's all the same except that it's happening on the 2nd. And while you're there at gizwiz.biz, make sure you play What the Heck Is It? We're going to be finding out at the end of this month or next?
At the end of this month, the end of August.
At the end of this month, we'll be figuring out what this is. You don't have much more time to get a guessing, so get on over to gizwiz.biz. And make a guess as to what this gadget is. This is a whole gadget. He's not doing anything sneaky, like this is a part of the gadget or anything. This is everything. So you have all the information you need. To me, this is very obvious. It is a triangle sprinkler. The sprinkler shoots up from the bottom and gives a nice triangle. It hooks onto the end of the hose. This is hard to come up with an idea every single week on the spot. It's a triangle sprinkler, obviously. Not very clever. Hopefully you have more clever answers. You have all the time in the world to make a guess. There's 12 Mad Magazines, if you actually know the answer, for correct answers, and 24, double the Mad Magazines, sometimes even more, for cute, funny, hilarious answers. We love to make that a segment on the show, so get your funny answers to us. And this is what you're playing for, the Mad Magazine.
For October issue.
It has the emoji, the poop emoji, another poop issue of Mad. That's great.
Oh, I thought it was a Hershey kiss. I'm glad you cleared that up for me.
You don't want to be kissing that one, Diggy D. Yeah, so that copy of Mad signed by Dickie D himself. This guy. That about wraps it up for this show. I guess we'll see you next week on the Giz Wiz.
I'll be here.